Hello everyone, today I'm going to explain a very important reaction, Corey-Fuchs reaction. In this, I'll be talking about general introduction, mechanism and examples. This reaction was developed in the year 1972 by E.J. Corey and P.L. Fuchs. Basically, it is one carbon homologation to corresponding terminal alkynes using carbon tetrabromide and triphenylphosphine. In this, the starting material is an aldehyde, so it is a transformation of an aldehyde to one carbon chain extended alkynes. This is the general reaction. This whole process involves three steps. First is conversion of aldehyde to dibromoolefin, dibromoolefin to lithium acetylide, which finally generates terminal alkynes. In this, formation of dibromoolefin can be done by two possible ways. First is addition of aldehyde 1 equivalent to a mixture of triphenylphosphine 4 equivalents and carbon tetrabromide 2 equivalents. The second method is addition of aldehyde to a reagent which is prepared by mixing zinc dust 2 equivalents with triphenylphosphine 2 equivalents and carbon tetrabromide 2 equivalents. This first step is a Wittig type of step. In this, method 2 is generally preferred because it gives higher yield of dibromoolefin and also simplifies the isolation procedure. Second step is conversion of dibromoolefin to lithium acetylide, which on hydrolysis generates terminal alkyne. The mechanism involves three steps. First step is generation of phosphorus ulide. This is Wittig type of reaction in which triphenylphosphine first abstracts one bromide ion, generating a tribromomethyl carbon ion and triphenyl bromide phosphonium ion. Then the negatively charged carbon atom attacks on positively charged phosphorus, so there is formation of carbon phosphorus bond. Then second equivalent of triphenylphosphine is added, which abstracts one bromide ion, and this leads to the formation of phosphorus ulide. This is Wittig type of reaction. Second step is reaction of phosphorus ulide with aldehyde. As we know that in phosphorus ulide, phosphorus is positively charged and there is nucleophilic carbon atom. So this nucleophilic carbon atom attacks on electrophilic site, that is carbonyl carbon of aldehyde, where oxygen acquires negative charge. Then this negatively charged oxygen atom attacks on positively charged phosphorus, generating a four-membered ring, which is oxophosphatane ring. And then since phosphorus has tendency to form bond with oxygen, so there is generation of dibromoolefin and triphenylphosphine oxide is the byproduct. Third step is conversion of dibromoolefin to terminal alkyne. In this, the corresponding terminal alkyne can be accomplished by treatment of dibromoolefin with two equivalents of N-butyl lithium at around minus 78 degrees centigrade. Basically, it involves lithium halogen exchange followed by elimination, and this process is then followed by hydrolysis. The intermediate here is lithium acetylide, which can be treated with number of electrophiles to produce a wide variety of useful derivatives. During this whole mechanism, there is generation of carbene as an intermediate, but that is generated in situ. This can be proven by deuterium labeling, which shows that the reaction proceeds through carbene mechanism. Lithium bromide exchange is generally followed by alpha elimination to generate carbene, and then there is 1-2 shift which generates deuterium labeled terminal alkyne, which you can see in this example where dibromoolefin is treated with butyl lithium. So first step is lithium halogen exchange, and then there is alpha elimination of lithium bromide generating a carbene. Then deuterium shifts from one position to two, that is 1-2 shift generating a terminal alkyne. So this proves that during the reaction there is in situ generation of carbene as an intermediate. Now let's discuss the examples. This is the first example. You can see there is aldehyde functional group. First, it is treated with triphenylphosphine and carbon tetrabromide, which generates dibromide olefin, which on treatment with N-butyl lithium and methyl iodide generates a terminal alkyne. This is the second example. Here again, aldehyde is first treated with carbon tetrabromide, triphenylphosphine and zinc dust to generate dibromide olefin, and that on treatment with N-butyl lithium generates terminal alkyne. Remember, in first example we have used methyl iodide, that's why the alkyne is non-terminal, there is introduction of methyl group. Well, in second example we have used only N-butyl lithium, so there is transfer of hydrogen atom and hence terminal alkyne is obtained. So this was all about Corey-Fuchs reaction. I'll just revise this. It is conversion of aldehydes into terminal higher alkynes having one carbon atom more compared to the starting material. In this, the reagent used is carbon tetrabromide, triphenyl phosphine. Reaction proceeds via formation of dibromoolefin, which is converted into lithium acetylide, and lithium acetylide on hydrolysis generates terminal alkyne. Thank you.